Let us now study the theory of interference of two waves. This is the analysis I am going to execute, which I have already explained in the concept of interference of waves. Let's study it again, specifically for light intensities. Here, to start with, there are two coherent waves of frequency, angular frequency omega, and amplitudes E1 and E2. And these superpose at a point with the phase difference phi. Then individual displacements of the two waves at the point of superposition are given as, if these are y1 and y2, then y1 we can write as, say, it is E1 sine of omega t. Here I am assuming that the two waves are producing sinusoidal oscillations, and y2 we can write E2 sine of omega t minus phi. Here this minus phi implies the second wave is lagging in phase with respect to first wave by a phase angle phi. And here t equal to 0 is the time I am taking when the first wave arrives at the point of superposition. And here for light waves I can write that y1 and y2 both are representing electric field vector in medium for the two waves. As we have discussed that oscillation of electric field is basically responsible for all general phenomena or characteristics associated with light. So here if y1 and y2 are the individual displacements, then here we can write at the point of interference or at the point of superposition, a resulting displacement is, here y we can write as y1 plus y2, which is E1 sine omega t plus y2 is E2 sine omega t minus phi, which I can open here and I can write it as sine omega t cos phi minus cos omega t sine phi. And here in this expression, if I split the terms of omega t, which are the time oscillating factors, so here we can write it A1 plus E2 cos phi multiplied by sine omega t minus this A2 sine phi multiplied by cos omega t. Now, this is a factor which is a constant, does not depend on time, and this is again a factor which also does not depend on time. So, if I replace these factors with some other constant factors to combine this expression as, say, I am writing this as r cos theta, and here I am writing this as r sine theta. Then in this situation, the resulting displacement can be given as r sine omega t cos theta minus r sine theta cos omega t. Then this will become r sine of omega t minus theta. This is the expression I am getting. And this I am getting after replacing these two terms. Now let's continue on the next sheet. As we have seen that resulting displacement at the point of superposition is given as r sine of omega t. Here r is the resulting oscillation amplitude at the point of superposition. And here the value of r we can calculate from equations 1 and 2. Here we square the two equations and add, you can see this will result as the value of r, which will be under the root, this will be E1 plus E2 cos phi whole square plus E2 sine phi whole square. And if we further simplify it, we are getting the value of r to be E1 square plus, here you can see this A2 square cos square phi plus A2 square sine square phi will become A2 square plus another term which is left over is 2A1A2 cos phi. So, this is the value of resulting amplitude at the point of superposition of two coherent waves, which is given as A1 square plus A2 square plus 2A1A2 cos phi. And dividing these two equations, equation 2 by equation 1 will give us the initial phase of the resulting oscillation. Here the value of theta, we can see we are getting it 10 inverse of this A2 sin phi by A1 plus A2 cos phi. So, these are the parameters of resulting oscillation after superposition. And here you can see this gives us an idea that this can be obtained by assuming A1 and A2 are two vectors having the angle between the two vectors as the phase difference. So, these are the result of parallelogram law of vector addition. Like if I consider an amplitude A1 as vector and A2 as another vector which is lagging in phase by an angle phi, which we have seen the second wave was lagging in phase with respect to first one. So, the resulting vector, which is the vector sum of these two, is given as R, and with respect to the initial direction of first vector, this is the initial phase of the resulting oscillation, which is theta. So, using this vector addition law, we can calculate directly the resulting amplitude. So, this is just a way to obtain by assuming amplitude as vectors and the angle between them is equal to the phase difference between the two waves. So, in case whenever more than two waves superpose which are coherent, then vector addition method is more useful for calculation of resulting amplitude at this point. Here we can see in this expression R is maximum. One in this expression the value of cos phi is equals to plus 1. If we substitute the value of cos phi to be plus 1, this implies the value of maximum amplitude is A1 plus A2. And this is the maximum amplitude at the point of superposition when our cos phi is plus 1, or here we can write phi is equals to, in this situation, cos phi if it is plus 1, the value of phi we can write as 2n pi. So, resulting amplitude is maximum when the two waves are in same phase. 2n pi is the phase difference when the oscillations are in same phase. And this is the situation when we call the interferences constructive, or this termed as constructive interference. Similarly, here the value of R is minimum after superposition when the value of cos phi is equals to minus 1, which happens when the value of phi is equals to 2n plus 1 pi. That happens when the two oscillations superpose in opposite phase. So, the phase angle or multiple of pi is corresponding to opposite phase oscillations. And this is the situation when the minimum amplitude in this situation is, here if cos phi is minus 1, this will be A1 minus A2 magnitude. And this is the interference which we call destructive interference when the resulting amplitude produced at the point of superposition is minimum. So, constructive interference takes place when the two waves superpose in same phase. And destructive interference takes place when the two waves superpose in opposite phase at the point of superposition. In parallel, from this expression here, you can see if A1 is equals to A2 is equals to A, the resulting amplitude will see when the two waves are of equal amplitude. Here you can see the value of R we are getting is root of 2A square plus 2A square cos phi. And here 1 plus cos phi we can write as 2 cos square phi by 2. So, the resulting amplitude we are getting is 2a cos phi by 2. On simplifying, you are getting it. So, this is the resulting amplitude when the two waves of equal amplitude superpose with a phase difference phi. And here we can see if amplitudes are equal, for constructive interference, maximum amplitude will be 2a and minimum amplitude will be 0. zero amplitude oscillation means the particle or E vector will be at rest, that means the amplitude will remain zero, that means always the displacement at the point of oscillation will remain zero.